The NRF52 chips from Nordic should be much better for Bluetooth low energy projects than the ESP32. Is this true? Can we use them with the Arduino IDE? And which boards are available? Let's have a closer look. Gritzy YouTubers, here is the guy with the Swiss accent, with a new episode and fresh ideas around sensors and microcontrollers. Remember, if you subscribe, you will always sit in the first row. I used Bluetooth Low Energy or BLE on the ESP32 as presence detector or to play with the Polar heart rate monitor. When I measured the energy consumption, it became clear that the architecture of the ESP32 is not made for battery-operated BLE. It consumed way too much energy. Back then, I already knew that Nordic semiconductors specialized in BLE chips. But they used a proprietary IDE, which was not acceptable for me. Times have changed since then. This is why we will search for available boards with Nordic chips. Check the available supporting software for the Arduino IDE. Build a BLE temperature sensor and a receiver for a Polar heart rate monitor. And of course, we will measure the power consumption. Let's start with the boards. A few years ago, Adafruit and others made boards with the NRF52832. It offered BLE and a powerful ARM Cortex-M4F, but only had 512 KB flash and 64 KB SRAM. Later, NRF52840 boards came to the market. They had the same processor, but 1 MB flash and 256 KB SRAM. The BLE transmitter also had 8 dBm power instead of the 4 of the predecessors, leading to a bigger range. So it makes no more sense to buy a board with the old chip, and we focus on boards with the NRF52840. To my knowledge, Arduino had the first board with this chip, the Nano 33 BLE. It has a U-Blox module aboard. I showed this board already in video number 298 in November 2019, but I have never used it so far. Adafruit offers this chip on several boards, the Feather and the ItsyBitsy. Both use the same module. They only differ in the form factor and the peripherals. The next board I found is the Maker Diary. It has the shape of a USB dongle. Because all NRF52 boards offer native USB support, they do not need a separate USB to serial chip. Then I got this tiny XIAO board from Seeds. It seems to be ideal for a beacon or a sensor application. SparkFun and others also have boards that I do not own, so we have a choice of boards available. And now comes the more complex topic, how to program these boards with the Arduino IDE. In 2016, Sandeep Mistry already started to write an NRF52 support for the Arduino IDE. The Arduino Nano 33 BLE was introduced around 2018, and it was supported by the Arduino Embed OS core and the Bluetooth library. I did not find a reference to Sandeep's work, so I assume this is an independent development. The Arduino version only supports their boards. Then came Adafruit with their version, and they included another BLE library, Bluefruit. The Adafruit core also supports a few non-Adafruit boards, and the Bluefruit library seems to be quite comprehensive with lots of examples and a good documentation. The Adafruit version seems to be based on Sandeep's version. At least they support his project, and I found his copyright in some of the Adafruit files. Maybe you know more about the relationship between the two and which one is better. Sandeep's core supports a few boards, but not the ones from Arduino nor Adafruit. Then came Seeds. Yes, with 3E. They came up with yet another core. Also here, I do not know if it is based on Arduino's, Sandeep's or Adafruit's work, but it only supports its own XIAO boards. So the situation is not good. Too much choice if you ask me. It seems that Nordic is not interested in the maker community and does not step in as Espressif or STM did. So I had to decide. Because I have two Adafruit boards and the Bluefruit examples, as well as the documentation is good, I went with Adafruit. Because I made a mistake while upgrading the bootloader of one of my Adafruit boards, I discovered that I could also use the XIAO board with Adafruit's code. I just flashed the bootloader to the XIAO, tweaked the boards.txt and created new variant files. Because I did not want to use the GPIOs of the XIAO board, I mainly fixed the LED pins. Maybe somebody else already has those files or creates and shares them with the community. So we can use the NRF52 boards with the Arduino IDE. A significant difference to most other boards we use is that they have native USB support in the chip, and their bootloader creates a disk drive when plugged into the PC. Upgrading the bootloader is easy. Just drag and drop the new version to this disk and wait for a few seconds. The chip reboots and starts with the upgraded version. Cool. Please refer to Adafruit's documentation if you have an old board version. The programming is done as usual with the Arduino IDE via a serial connection. Because we have plenty of other good chips for projects without Bluetooth, I would not choose the NRF52 chip for such projects. The chance that one or the other library does not work is high, but BLE seems to be its strength. So let's build a Bluetooth temperature sensor. You remember from video number 174, BLE offers two roles, central and peripheral. Peripheral devices are low power, resource constrained devices like heart rate monitors or beacons. They connect to more powerful central devices like smartphones or tablets with more processing power, memory and battery. The communication between these roles is based on standardized general attribute or GAT profiles. You find profiles for many applications like the one for environmental sensing. Each of these services has a UUID. Environmental sensing has 181A hex, for example. These services offer characteristics like temperature with its assigned number 2A6E. Now we only need a sensor and a sketch. I found this blue term sketch, which reads the temperature and transfers it via BLE. Let's have a look at the sketch. First, we have to define the service. Its name is ES_SVC, Environmental Service. This is its UUID. We found it here. Then we have to define the characteristic. We find its UUID at the same place. The UUIDs are standardized, but the names can be defined by you. This part of the sketch is for reading the temperature from this one wire sensor. We will not cover it in today's video. In setup, we start and read the sensor and start BLE, as well as set some names. Then we define some parameters and start the service. It will transport a 2-byte integer value. Because we want that our sensor continuously transmits values, we start at vertexing. Now it should transmit a temperature reading every 100 milliseconds. After 30 seconds, the interval is increased, by the way. In loop, we regularly measure the temperature and replace the transmitted value. No sleep function is used. After uploading the sketch to an ItsyBitsy board, we can check if it works. We start NRF Connect on our smartphone. And really, we see a device called Blue Term Device, the name given to our ItsyBitsy. Its signal strength is -64 dBm, which suggests that it is close to the iPhone. We can now connect to it and see the environmental service with the UUID 181A. And we see the model number string we defined before. But the essential characteristic is the temperature, of course. If we heat the sensor, the value changes. So our BLE sensor works. Now we could create or find an app that displays the temperature. Next, we want to create a device that receives BLE messages. The typical example is to receive the signal of a polar heart rate monitor. Here I use the example file. It displays my heart rate. You see, creating YouTube videos is not arduous. The heart rate stays relatively low. So the NRF52 chip can be used to create sensors as well as receivers for messages. This is very similar to the ESP32. No need to change to a new chip family. Now comes the most crucial question. Can we create a really low power battery operated beacon? Let's use the XIAO for this test and create a standard Apple beacon using the Adafruit example file. To test it, I use the NRF beacon app. It should show the Mona Lisa when the iPhone approaches the beacon. You can imagine that such a beacon could be used for many applications. But it has to be low power if we want to run it on battery. Looking at the sketch, we see that the loop is empty. So the loop does not consume energy. Very good. And even better, a command called suspend loop promises even to save more power. So let's try. I connect the tiny XIAO board to the Power Profiler Kit 2 to measure its power consumption. Here is the result. Large peaks up to 15 mA, small peaks of 2 mA and nearly nothing in between. The large peaks appear every 100 milliseconds. This is what we selected here. The average power consumption is 590 microamperes, which is very low compared to the ESP32, which consumes milliamperes for the same purpose. Let's stretch the time between peaks to 200 milliseconds. Now the power consumption is 100 microamperes less. If we extend the interval to 1 second, it only consumes 400 microamperes on average. Using two AAA batteries with a capacity of around 1000 milliampere hours, it would run 69 days. With a 1 second interval, it would be 104 days. Not bad for a device that continuously transmits. The temperature sensor consumed 890 microamperes with fast advertising and 717 microamperes with slow advertising. Also a good value compared with the ESP32. Did we reach what we wanted? Yes and no. We found different boards with the NRF52840 chip in different form factors. This chip is supported by the Arduino IDE. Unfortunately, at least three different solutions exist. All of them support different boards. So we have to decide which one we choose according to the hardware we want to use. It would be much better if Nordic would decide on one and support it for all boards. I decided on the Adafruit solution because it has a lot of examples and good documentation. I was able to create a BLE temperature sensor and a polar heart rate monitor. So both scenarios, peripheral and central, are supported. And I measured the power consumption of a simple beacon. It was below 600 microamperes, which is much, much better than what I measured with the ESP32. But it is still higher than a standard beacon, which runs for 1 year on a simple coin cell. Some of those beacons also use the NRF52840 chips. So I assume it should be possible to reduce the consumption further. One possibility was to extend the transmitting interval to 1 second. This led to a 30% reduced power consumption. For sure, the microphone and the IMU sensor of the XIAO Sense consume some current. But I could not find out how much. And I have no standard XIAO board available. Maybe you know some tricks to reduce current? This was all for today. As always, you find all the relevant links in the description. I hope this video was useful or at least interesting for you. If true, please consider supporting the channel to secure its future existence. Thank you. Bye.